first Sunday after the Epiphany. We celebrate the baptism of our Lord. Every year we do that. And so the church designates this day as an especially appropriate day to celebrate the sacrament of baptism and also the sacrament of confirmation. Now, confirmation is grounded in baptism, as is ordination for that matter. All baptized people are called into the body of Christ for a purpose beyond ourselves, and that's to participate in God's mission, to restore humankind to union with God and each other, to be outward visible signs of Christ to the world, to be an epiphany people. And to be an epiphany people, we are called to embody the love of Jesus, a love offered without conditions, to embody the grace of Jesus, unmerited, unearned grace, to embody the forgiveness of Jesus, who forgives from the cross before we apologize, before anyone makes their confession, before anyone repents, Jesus forgives, to embody the compassion of Jesus, who touches the leper, to embody the justice of Jesus who seeks a just world, to embody the mercy of Jesus for when we fail, to be the good news of God's love in the flesh. At baptism, what was true all along is made known. Specifically, today's baptismal candidates, along with you and me, are children of God. When Jesus is baptized, and is coming up out of the water, the voice from heaven proclaims, and we heard this moments ago, "You are my son, the beloved. With you, I am well pleased." And those words are meant for today's baptismal candidates and you and me. You are God's daughter. You are God's son. What was true all along is made known to us. Which is the definition of an epiphany. You are created in God's image, true all along and proclaimed at baptism. You were born for that. Born to make manifest the glory of God. Those being baptized today are born for that. Playing small does not serve the world. Let your light shine. We are an epiphany people. We are created in the image of God, marked as Christ's own forever, to participate in God's dream.